KVR Maths Academy, maths an easy way.
Hi viewers, welcome to KVR Maths Academy. This is the second part of conceptual video of pair of linear equations in two variables of 10th class mathematics, right? So already in first video itself, we have discussed about definition, uses and solution. In solutions, graphical method we have discussed. So in this video, let us discuss the remaining methods and fourth, relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations, right? Yes, already graphical method in first video we have discussed, no? Now model method. Model method not given in our textbook, so no need of this one, skip it. Next, let us discuss algebraic method. So algebraic method, there are three sub methods are there: substitution method, elimination method and cross multiplication method. So let us discuss one by one, right? Yes, with the same example only let us discuss. So what is that example? Already we have taken, no? 3x plus 2y is equal to 80 and 4x plus 3y is equal to 110, right? In algebraic method, first substitution method, let us discuss substitution method, right? How can you use this substitution method? Here two equations are there. First one is 3x plus 2y is equal to 80 and 4x plus 3y is equal to 110, right? Yeah, take first equation. 3x plus 2y is equal to 80 is there, right? Yes, first to find the value of y. Here 2y is equal to 80 minus 3x, isn't it? 80 minus 3x. Y is equal to 80 minus 3x by 2, isn't it? 80 minus 3x by 2, y is equal to. So here suppose this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. So y is equal to 80 minus 3x by 2, substitute in the equation 2. Y is equal to 80 minus 3x by 2, substitute in equation 2. Right, what is the equation 2? 4x plus 3y is equal to 110. Isn't it? Yeah. So 4x plus y value only, na? So in the place of y, let us substitute this one. 3 into 80 minus 3x by 2 is equal to 110. Isn't it? In the place of y, we have substituted this one. 80 minus 3x by 2. Right. This is 4x plus 3 into 80. 380 is a 240 minus 33 is a 9x by 2 is equal to 110, isn't it? Yes. Here what is the LCM of here, this one? Yes, 2 is the LCM. This will be one time get cancelled. 1 2 is a 2 into 4x 8x plus 240 minus 9x is equal to 110. Understood clearly here? 2 4 is 8 directly, otherwise. So that is equal to 8x minus 9x. How much? Yes, minus x plus 240 is equal to 2 transferred to this side. Here divide, no? Is this side means if you transfer it to this side, this will be multiplied. 110 is 220. 220. So minus x is equal to 220 minus 240 transferred to this side, plus 240 will become minus 240. Yes, minus x is equal to 220 minus 240 will be minus 20. Minus minus get cancelled, x is equal to 20. So x is equal to 20 we have got. Right. So x means here the cost of a book is equal to 20. Right. So x is equal to 20, substitute in the value of in equation number 1. X is equal to 20, substitute in 1. What is that? 3x plus 2y is equal to 80. So x is equal to 3 into 20 plus 2y is equal to 80. This is 60. So 2y is equal to 80 plus 60 will become minus 60. So there is 80 minus 60, 20. So y is equal to 20 by 2. 2 tens are. So y is equal to 10. So x is equal to 20 and y is equal to 10. X means the cost of the notebook is 20. The cost of the pen is 10. So if you substitute here, this will satisfy or not? Yes, 3 20s are 60 plus 2 10s are 20. 60 plus 20 will be 80. Next, in the same way, 4 20s are 80 plus 3 10s are 30. 80 plus 30 will be 110. Satisfied or not? So this is the substitution method in algebraic method. Understood clearly? Yes, note it down. Next, elimination method. Elimination method. So with the same example only, I am explaining. So what is elimination method? Yes. So first, here two equations are there, no? So first we have to equalize the coefficients of x or coefficients of y. Then we have to cancel both. Then we'll find the x and y values. Right? Yes. See here coefficient of x is 3, here coefficient of x is 4. So what we have to do? Yes, here multiply the equation, whole equation with 4, and multiply this whole equation with 3. Right? Yes. Equation 1 into 4 gives, what happens? Yes, 4 3s are 12x plus 4 2s are 8y is equal to 480s are 320. This is equation number 3. Right? Next, 2 into s coefficient of 3, x 3, 2 into 3. Equation number 2 multiplied with number 3. Yes? 4 3s are 12x plus 3 3s are 9y is equal to 3 110s are 330. This is equation number 4. Right? Now 3 minus 4 gives. Equation number 3 minus equation number 4 gives. This is 12x plus 8y is equal to 320. 12x plus 9y is equal to 330. Now subtract this one. This will be minus, minus, minus. Here, plus 12x minus 12x get be cancelled, no? So, we have eliminated x. The remaining will be y only. So, this is only elimination method. Understood? Yes, 8y minus 9y minus y is equal to 320 minus 330 minus 10. Both sides minus minus get cancelled. That implies y is equal to 10. Y is equal to 10. So, y is equal to 10. Substitute in equation number 1, that is 3x plus 2y is equal to 80, no? So 3x plus 2 into 10 is equal to 80. 3x is equal to 80, 2 tens are 20. 20 transferred to this side, that will be minus 20. Minus 20, 3x is equal to 60. X is equal to 60 by 2. 60 by 3. This is 20. Therefore, x is equal to 20. And y is equal to 10. X is equal to 20 and y is equal to 10. These are only we have got in the substitution method and graph method also, no? Yes. So this is elimination method. If you want to note it down once. Understood clearly? So cross multiplication method. So this is also not in our textbook, but for idea I am explaining, right? Yes, cross multiplication method with the same example only, I will explain, right? Yeah. Look here, first write on a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. These are the pair of linear equation in two variables. So here x, y values we have to find using this formula. Will be, see, look here. X by, we have to use this one. X by B1C2 minus B2C1 is equal to x by B1C2 minus B2C1 by is equal to y by C1A2 minus C2A1 is equal to C x by B1C2 minus B2C1 is equal to y by A1C2 minus A2C1 minus A1C2 or C2A1 is equal to 1 by here, not is C1, 1 by we should take, because coefficients only, no, we are taking variables. So that is 1 by A1B2 minus A2B1. So this is the formula, cross multiplication method. So that's why here what we should use, x is equal to B1C2 minus B2C1 transfer to that side for equal to this means B1C2 minus B2C1 by A1B2 minus A2B1. This is x. Understood? Next, in the same way, y is equal to C1A2 minus C2A1 by A1B2 minus A2B1. Y means C1A2 minus C2A1, we have to transfer here. So this will be like this. So using of this formula, so cross multiplication method, we are using formulas, no? So that's why this is also called as formula method. What is that? Formula method also we will call this. Understood? Yeah. So let us write like this, these two equations. This is 3x plus 2y minus 80 is equal to 0. 3x plus 2y minus 80 is equal to 0. Next, 4x plus 3y minus 110 is equal to 0. Now apply this one. This is A2, B2, C2. A1 is 3, B1 is 2, C1 is minus 80. Here A2 is 4, B2 is 3, C2 is minus 110. So apply here, x is equal to B1 means 2 into C2. This is minus 110 minus B2. B2 is 3 into C1 is minus 80 by A1, B2, 3 into 3, 3 into 3 minus A2, B1, 4 into B1, 2, 4 into 2. Right, so that is equal to 2 110s are minus 220, minus into minus plus, 3 80s are 40, 240, 3 80s are 240. By 3, 3s are 9, minus 4, 2s are 8. So, minus 220 plus 240. Yes. How much? 20. Plus 20 by 9 minus 8 will be 1. So, that is equal to 20. So, x value we have got how much? 20. So, in the same way, y value. Y is equal to C1, A2. C1 minus 80 into A2 is 4 minus C2 minus 110 minus 110 into A1 is 3 by A1B2, that is 3 into 3 minus 4 into 2. Both are same only, na? Yes, that is equal to minus 320 minus into minus plus 3 110s are 330 by 9 minus 8. This is 330 minus 320. Yes, 10. 10 by 9 minus 8 is 1. So that is equal to 10. So y is equal to how much we have got? 10. So in all the methods, we have got, say, x is equal to 20, y is equal to 10. Understood? Therefore, the cost of the notebook is 20 and the cost of the pen is 10. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down. Okay, completed na? Finally, I'll explain about relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. Relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. Finally, relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. Relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. Look here. Already we have taken, what are the pair of linear equations in two variables? A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0. A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. These are the pair of linear equations in two variables, no? So the following situations can be arise. See, what are those? First one, A1 by, if A1 by A2 is equal to, is not equal to B1 by B2. If A1 by A2, the coefficients of x and the ratio between coefficient of x is not equal to the ratio between coefficients of y, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the lines are consistent. Lines are consistent. Consistent with unique solution. Consistent with unique solution. Look here. If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, then the pair of linear equations are consistent and with unique solution. These are independent lines. What are these? Independent lines. Understood clearly? Yes. Second one is, what is that? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2 means. Here A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Then lines are consistent and these have unique solution and these are independent lines. Right. So here A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2. These both are equal coefficients and not equal to the ratio is C1 by C2. Then the lines are, the pair of linear equations in two variables are inconsistent. What are those? Inconsistent without any solution without or simply no solution. Next, these are independent lines. These are parallel lines. These will be parallel lines. See, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2, but not equal to C1 by C2. Then these are inconsistent. Next, the lines have no solution and these are parallel lines. Final situation is, look here. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 and also equal to C1 by C2. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 and also equal to C1 by C2 means? Yes. These are all, yes, these both pair of linear equations in two variables are consistent. These are consistent. And how many solutions will be there? Here, unique solution, only one solution. Here, no solution. Here, in the third situation, infinite solutions. Infinite solutions and these lines are coincident lines. Understood clearly? The system is here consistent, here inconsistent and consistent. Consistent means here pair of linear equations in two variables are also called as simultaneous linear equations. No, if these are said to be consistent, these are at least having one solution. These are simultaneous linear equations are said to be consistent. At least they should have one solution. here unique solution, one solution is there, infinite solutions are there. So that's why these are also consistent and this is also consistent. So how can you represent graphically for these three situations? Right. See here, first situation. Look here. Yeah, your consistent now unique solutions. So suppose this is x, this is y. No, simply I'm drawing. So these are like this. See how many solutions? Unique, only one solution is there. One solution. Right. So these are consistent lines. These are consistent. Next, independent lines, these both are. So one is, this is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. This is a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Right? Next, second condition, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So how can you represent graphically? Look here. Suppose this is like this. Like this. So these are parallel lines. X, Y. Parallel lines. This is A1X plus B1Y plus C1 is equal to 0. Another one is A2X plus B2Y plus C2 is equal to 0. Right? In third situation, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So how can you represent this one graphically? So this is X, Y. Yeah. Suppose this is the line like this. What I'm saying, infinite solutions and coincident lines. So this coincident lines means like this. These both are coincident lines. So this is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0. And this is a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. So for this graph, these are consistent, these are also consistent. First and third situations are consistent. Next, in first situation, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 means there is only one solution and these are independent lines. Here in second situation, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is not equal to c1 by c2 means these are parallel lines and inconsistent parallel lines. So those have no solution. Parallel lines does not have any solution, no? Yes, these are not having any solution. Next, in third situation, a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. So all are equal here. So these are also consistent and these are coincident lines and these lines having infinite solutions. Have you understood clearly? Yes, note it down if you want. So this is the relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. Relation between coefficients and nature of system of equations. So this is the end of the concept of pair of linear equation in two variables. So next video onwards, I'll explain exercises problems. Right? Okay viewers, if you like my video, please like and share. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Thank you very much.